In this video, we're going to look at using group grades in the color page. They're a very helpful tool for applying color grades to multiple clips simultaneously. To add a clip to a group, right-click on its thumbnail. As we've not yet created any groups, we'll want to select Add to New Group. I'll call the group Interview A. It's possible to add several clips to a group at once. Here, I'll select two clips and add them using the Add into Current Group menu option. Anytime you select a clip that belongs to a group, you'll see this chain icon under the thumbnail. The chain icon also appears on the other clips that are affected by this group grade. On any clip in your timeline that's not in a group, you'll get two tabs in the node viewer, Clip and Timeline. As this clip is now in a group, there are two additional tabs, Group Pre-Clip and Group Post-Clip. Any grades that you want to apply to your entire group should be placed in one of these tabs. But why are there two, and which one should you use? To answer that question, it's helpful to understand DaVinci Resolve's order of operations. Operations in the color page are performed in a specific order. For example, the first node to be applied to an image will be the leftmost. But even within that node, if you apply more than one correction, for example, a primary wheels adjustment and a curves adjustment, they will be executed in a very specific order. The corrections made using your primary wheels will influence the corrections that you make with the curves. And the corrections made in this first node will affect the corrections you decide to make in the second node. As a result, a colorist will carefully choose the order in which corrections are made to an image. Now, let's go back to our interview clip. Even though this clip is now in a group, specific corrections can still be applied to this clip individually in the Clip tab, or to every clip in the timeline using the Timeline tab. The Group Pre-Clip and Group Post-Clip tabs allow you to choose whether those group corrections are applied before or after any clip-specific corrections are applied. If a group of clips all required the same primary correction, I might choose to perform that correction pre-clip. That means I can make secondary corrections at the clip level, and those secondary corrections will be executed, rightfully so, after the primary corrections performed in the pre-clip grade. Alternatively, if I'm using a group grade to apply a creative look to a collection of shots, I would probably choose to perform that in the Group Post-Clip tab. This allows me to use Group Pre-Clip to apply primary corrections and Clip to shot match each clip individually, so they will work with my creative look. In the instance of this project, I'd like to use groups to simplify the process of grading the interview. As the interview is constructed from several takes, using remote grades, as discussed in the previous lesson, won't work as effectively. I'd have to create 10 grades, one for each take and angle. So I'll continue grouping the shots into two groups, one for the A camera and one for the B. It's tedious doing this, though, in this view. Instead, I'm going to switch to the lightbox. By default, the lightbox will show me every shot in the timeline. I can take advantage of the metadata I've already entered for this project to make the selection process even quicker. I'll make my own smart bin. I'm going to call it Interviews No Group. The first criteria is that the media pool scene contains interview. The next criteria is that the clip has no group. This will help me to filter out the shots I've already grouped. Hit plus, then set it up. Timeline properties group. Is. And then leave it blank. Now I'm only going to see the interview clips that have yet to add a group. Now this edit is pretty simple. There's not that many shots. But you can imagine how helpful the no group filter would be on a very large edit. Also, if the camera letters were specified in my clip metadata, this would have been even easier because I could have filtered by camera angle. I don't have that set up, so I'll just do this final bit by hand. Holding Command or Control, I can select all the A camera clips one at a time. Now, right-click and add them to the A camera group. Finally, let's add those B cam shots to a group of their own. Fantastic! Now we're done. Don't forget to remove your filter by hitting All Clips. We can now close the lightbox. In the color page, I can grade the entire interview with now just two grades. I'll make an adjustment to the A camera. As this is a primary correction, I'm going to choose to do it pre-clip. I'll give the gamma a small push of blue and add a little more contrast. Thus far, we've used group grades for technical operations. They are also great for applying creative grades. I'm going to add all the dance shots to a group so I can uniformly apply a creative look to them. As all the dance shots are in the second video track, I can make selecting them easier by disabling track 1. You can do that from the color page by opening the timeline viewer and clicking on V1. Now only track 2 clips are visible. I'll select the first clip in the dance sequence, hold down on Shift, and click on the last clip. Now that they're selected, I can add them to a group called Dance. As this is a creative look, I'm going to apply it to the Post Clip tab. I'll turn everything black and white with the monochrome checkbox and the RGB mixer, reduce the gamma and contrast, make a new node, and then add a sepia tone. This look is now being applied to every shot in the dance sequence. I can see, though, that some clips are too bright to work properly with this look. I can better match these shots by adding adjustments at the clip level. I'll reduce the brightness of this clip with the reduction in gamma. Now it better matches the other shots in this group, but as that correction was applied at the clip level, it only affects this clip. I hope you enjoyed this in-depth look at using groups to create grades. And as you can see, groups are very useful for a variety of technical and creative tasks that you might perform when grading. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Consider sharing it with a fellow editor or colorist, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos. And hey, one more thing before I go. We have some pretty big news. We're working on our first complete DaVinci Resolve course. It will teach you everything you need to know to edit, color, and mix audio in DaVinci Resolve. Like the content on our channel, it's designed to be comprehensive yet efficient. We think it will be particularly helpful to editors with experience in other NLEs like Premiere who are looking to expand their skill set. But if you're a beginner, we think you'll love the course too. We just won't be spending lots of time on concepts that editors are already familiar with. We're going to get straight to the good stuff. Well, more on all of that soon. Thanks so much for watching.